Welcome to Cambridge House Live. I'm Bridgitte Anderson, and Chris Lewicki is with me. You are the president, chief engineer, and I don't think I've ever said this, the chief asteroid miner at Planetary Resources. Welcome. Nice to see you.
Thank you very much. Nice to be here today with you, Bridgitte.
Chris, let's start off right from the beginning. You are endeavoring to be the world's first asteroid miner. So tell me a little bit about what this means.
Well, there are a lot of resources right here on the Earth, and of course all the businesses that are involved in recovering those resources are right here today. Those resources, though, exist in a broader universe, so to speak, the resources out in space. And at Planetary Resources, we want to actually develop a way to acquire those resources to help explore space and to help expand the economic sphere of humanity off the surface of this planet deeper into the solar system.
So what attracted you to asteroids? How did this ever come to be?
Well, I think in a little part because we believe it's possible. My background is one of aerospace engineering. I spent 10 years with the National Aeronautics and Space Administration with NASA. And actually, 9 years ago today is our anniversary of landing Opportunity on Mars. And I was a flight director that night for the Mars missions when we landed on it and drove Opportunity on the surface. And I'll tell you, that's an awful lot of fun. It's an exciting thing to do. And exploration is certainly something that drives a lot of us. And the opportunity to explore space and explore asteroids and space resources is really what attracted me to the opportunity.
Is that where you started thinking about this opportunity when you were working at NASA then?
I'll talk about my co-founders. One is Dr. Peter Diamandis, chairman and co-founder of the XPRIZE Foundation. And then Eric Anderson, who is the chairman and founder of Space Adventures. And these two gentlemen actually started the space tourism industry out of something that you thought would never come to be, but now we have a number of businesses from which you can buy a ticket to go into space, and a few have gone already. And their vision was really seeing the opportunity for what's really going to be the economic engine to expand us into new frontiers. And as every business here today knows, it's resources that really make the world go around, and it's resources that support our economy and our livelihood. And if we're going to move into space, it'll be the resources of space that help us move and stay there.
So why asteroids? What do they offer that we don't have enough of on Earth?
Well, I have with me today actually a little piece of an asteroid. This
Fantastic.
Is an iron meteorite. And what we know about asteroids actually is because we have been pelted with them for a very long time from space by the meteorites. So we can take those samples and study what's in them and find the volatile materials, water, organics, and also the metals like the iron, cobalt, and nickel that are in that meteorite sample. And then in some cases, even platinum group metals in concentrations much higher than they are here on Earth. And because of their location in space, asteroids actually represent the most accessible places in the solar system right off this planet. It's actually easier to get to about 15% of the asteroids than it is to land on the moon.
Okay, so easier to get to 15%, but is it really easy at all? Like, how practical is this? What are the challenges?
Well, we're starting out in terms of developing a lot more information. We are in the prospecting phase of developing this, and we consider ourselves a junior engineering company of sorts. We want to create a lot more information that we can make the decision on which asteroids have the valuable material that would be worth recovering and developing, and how are we actually going to develop the technology to recover that material. So our focus today is on prospecting and creating kind of what I'm familiar with, creating spaceships that will go out and prospect to that and give the information to make those decisions on.
Can you tell me a little bit more about the process of how you would collect them then? I mean, I know you're working on that technology,
sure.
But just maybe in really kind of big terms.
Well, this is something where the ore body is something very unfamiliar to traditional mining. You have an object out in space orbiting the sun. Some of them could be the size of this table, very small. Some of them could be the size of the city of Vancouver, very large. And how you would approach each one of those could be very different. Now, what is unique about this environment in space is that there is not very much gravity. So a lot of the processes we'll have to develop, we'll have to create our own gravity. So this is something that is a little bit of a challenge, but it's also an advantage because we won't need heavy machinery to move around tons and tons of material. If you've ever seen the astronauts in space move things around, sometimes they can do it with just the tip of their finger.
It sounds like it would be extremely expensive, and you've got some high-profile names and some people who have a lot of money who are already supporting you.
Absolutely.
So tell me about some of those people who are backing you.
So our backers are some very wealthy and famous and really visionary people. We have a number of people who were involved in the founding of Google, Larry Page, the CEO, and Eric Schmidt, the executive chairman. We have other Americans like Ross Perot Jr., who is into real estate and oil. And then innovators like Charles Simoni, who is actually one of the developers of the Microsoft Office Suite. And he actually himself went into space twice to the International Space Station. And all of these gentlemen really see an opportunity that we're just at the beginning of. And they are at a place in life where they can kind of take that bet and have that long view to see if this is something that will pan out.
And also Richard Branson from Virgin. So what is his interest then?
So Richard Branson, we're actually partnered with Virgin Galactic. They are creating a technology called Launcher One, which we'll plan on use to actually launching some of our spacecraft into space. And we hope to get Richard involved in some of what we're doing soon as well.
So you say that you're in the really kind of preliminary stages of this. How long do you think it's going to take to be able to determine if this is really feasible?
So today we're working on our asteroid prospecting technologies, and that actually starts with telescopes in space. We can actually understand enough about these materials in space because there's no dirt between us and the ore body, so we can use spectroscopy to characterize a metal asteroid from a carbonaceous asteroid. And we'll be doing that in about 2 years' time. Quickly after that, we'll be sending some of our spacecraft out actually to visit the asteroid themselves, and that's something that we'll do closer to the end of the decade. And we expect actually by the beginning of the next decade, in the 2020s, that we'll be starting to get the first samples of water off the surface of the asteroid, and that's something I'm going to talk about later this afternoon, about how water is so very important for exploring space.
Well, and one of the things that you're looking for in these asteroids is water. I guess people might say, well, isn't there enough here on Earth? And same with some of the other compounds or what you'd find in the asteroids. Why are you looking beyond Earth at all?
Well, we're looking beyond Earth because, as you know, in resource exploration and development, so much of the cost can be in transportation. And for us to carry everything that we need out into space to that future settlement that we may have is a very expensive proposition. So if we can use the water that's out there to support activities out in space, that will be extremely important.
I want to talk to you more about that because one of your goals is actually to try and lower the cost of space travel. So tell me a little bit about that and why you think that's important.
So we are not a government. We don't have a government mint to spend on our missions, even though we have some very wealthy people involved. Part of our business is actually to demonstrate more cost-effective ways to gather this information and to do this prospecting. So we're starting actually to use our knowledge from what we've learned with NASA and other industries and dramatically lower the cost of exploring space. So we look to be able to go out to asteroids for maybe 10% or even 5% the cost of what maybe NASA might cost from doing that. And with that, we'll be able to go to many more asteroids and gather a lot more data to recover the material from them.
Are you one of those people that think that, you know, in our lifetime that we're going to see space travel as a, I wouldn't say a regular thing, but certainly more frequent than we do now?
It is increasing every month, every day. It's gotten to where astronauts in space is a pretty routine thing. And even the tourists these days are pretty routine. And this is, I think, as a result of all the progress that we've been making. It's just another rung up the ladder on what we can do with our technology and what drives us and the opportunities that we're following.
And speaking of opportunities and some of the backers, are you still looking for more financing?
Oh, absolutely. We've got lots of people who are interested in supporting our mission and vision. And we're looking for people that have a kind of a long view on a resource opportunity, much like many things here on Earth. This is going to take a little while to develop, and it's going to take a fair amount of capital. And we've got a lot of that to begin with, but we're certainly always interested in people for joining the team.
What did people think when you first started talking about this idea?
Well, it's certainly an audacious goal, isn't it?
It's a big goal.
Yeah. My attitude on this has been, I come from a, you know, kind of a traditional aerospace background, participated in the landing of 3 different spacecraft on Mars, got a bachelor's and master's degree in aerospace engineering, and I've read plenty of science fiction. But what's really exciting about where we are today and where humanity has gotten to is all these miraculous things that we're experiencing are the result of someone decided that it could be done, and they're willing to take that chance. And I've had enough fun in doing what I'm doing that I'm going to dedicate this myself to this, and members of my team have dedicated themselves to this, and this is how we make the impossible possible. by pursuing these things.
It's a fantastic goal. I wish you all the best and good luck. Thanks for speaking with me.
All right. Thank you very much.